Hi, and welcome to the 2015 Western Dairy Management Conference here in Reno, Nevada. I'm Sarah Hill with Dairy Business Weekly, and I have here with me Mike Brook, who is professor with Kansas State University and a dairy extension specialist. Mike, tell us a little bit about this year's conference.
We've had a really great conference this year, just finishing up today. We've got about 1,730 We have about 1,730 registrants here for the conference. They're from about 43 different states. We've got about 14 actual different countries, but excluding the United States, represented here this time. So had a really wonderful turnout. Actually, attendance is up from the 2013 conference. So it's been a really great experience, I think, for everyone.
That sounds great. Tell us a little bit about the history of the conference.
So the conference actually started in 1993. So it's been going a very long time, and we only meet every other year, and there's a couple reasons we do that. Number one, we want to be able to present really some cutting edge information to dairy producers as well as the dairy industry, and planning a conference like that every year. Yes, there are things that change every year, but going every other year just allows us to do a better job of putting that information together in a format and in a 2.5-day program. So there's also a lot of work, obviously, involved in a conference like this, and having 2 years to prepare for that's pretty important.
It sounds like it. How is this conference organized and managed? Do you have a big crew of folks to help you out, or is it just a small core group?
So we really have, I guess, two different groups. We have a small core group that would really include myself, Dennis Armstrong, who is a retired dairy extension specialist from Arizona, and Mike Gamreth, who is also a retired extension specialist, but from Oregon State. The three of us really form a core committee. Then we have a large program planning committee, and that program planning committee actually includes professionals from 17 different universities, and then we also have five different dairy publications that participate in that process as well. And kind of how we work together with the program committee, we actually, for the 2015 conference, we met together in January of 2014 and went through a process of about a day total program where we basically plan and pick the topics that we think are important to the industry. And then Mike Gamreth does a lot of the work in terms of lining up the speakers that are chosen from that particular meeting and putting together our program format and producer panels and the various parts of the program. And generally by about March of the year before the conference, we have our program set and speakers locked in and ready to go to advertise that to the industry then.
That sounds like quite a lot of work and a big process, but it seems that the conference is going without a hitch. Are plans already in the works for the 2017 conference, or how is that underway?
So we are into the initial stages of some of that. The dates for the 2017 conference will be February 28th, March 1st, and the March 2nd of 2017. And again, it'll be the same week that it is this week. Part of the reason we do that is the Western Canadian Dairy Seminar is held the following week. And so we tried, since we're both meeting in the western part of North America, we try to stay off each other's weeks a bit. And that's a reason, one of the main reasons we choose those dates. And it also matches some other things that we have to be considerate of here in the West. Get much later in March, and you're in a situation where forage harvest is starting in some areas. And that's a real important time for dairy producers, obviously, to be on their farms when that's going on. So we are underway with the plans. The program planning won't occur until January, but we will be taking topics from producers today as they fill out the surveys.
That sounds great, Mike. So if a producer is not able to come to the conference or perhaps wants to give a suggestion of a topic, what are some ways that they could connect with the conference?
So there's, I guess, several different ways that a person could connect. One would be via our website, and that's just wdmc.org/2015QR. And that's actually a website that'll actually fit on your mobile phone. So if you're a mobile phone enthusiast, you can join us that way. Also, if you're connected with social media, we're on Twitter, and we're also on Facebook this year.
Fantastic. Well, could you share with us some highlights from this year's conference that have happened so far?
Well, I think one of the highlights of this conference is just the opportunity for people from industry, producers, dairy education specialists from across the United States to actually come together and meet and see each other in the hallways, maybe have lunch together or see each other at a hospitality event in the evening. So I think the social aspect of this conference is very, very important. Other aspects that I think were really important, we had a really, really wonderful panel that was sponsored by Dairy Management Inc. Yesterday afternoon, and it really addressed what's going on in our export dairy export markets. And as dairy export markets have grown rapidly in the last couple years and look to basically be a way where we expand our milk market beyond our borders, and very important to our milk price and success there, I think considering these opportunities as a producer and how you participate maybe directly in some of those opportunities, I think, is very, very important. So I think that was one of the, you know, I've heard a lot of good comments about that. Our producer panels that we have on various topics are always, always popular. And this year is no different. And again, I've heard several very, very positive comments about those panels as well.
Yeah, I know yesterday's genomic panel was very exciting and lots of opinions and discussion being held around that topic as a result of that panel. Is there anything else you'd like to add today?
Well, I just real quickly like to thank all of the sponsors. It's very, very, takes a lot of work to really make this conference go, and it takes a lot of efforts on everybody's parts. And if it wasn't for the support that our sponsors give this conference, we wouldn't be able to do that. Also, just like to recognize my fellow co-chairs, Dennis Armstrong and Mike Gamreth, for all that they do to make this conference happen, as well as all those individuals that serve on that program planning committee. We would not have the success we do at this conference if it wasn't for having a very, very strong program. And those 26, 27 individuals are really responsible for bringing those ideas to the table, identifying speakers, and helping us put together a program that will really meet the needs of the industry.
Well, thanks so much, Mike, and appreciate your time talking with us this morning. Once again, if you are interested in finding out more about the Western Dairy Management Conference, you can visit their website, or you can find out more on social media, Facebook and Twitter, Western Dairy Management Conference. Thanks again, and tune in soon.